Melissa Gordon is a contemporary artist exploring ideas of gesture and abstraction through the lens of feminism.
I am a painter primarily. I studied printmaking and painting in America. And then I came to Europe in my early 20s and went to a place called The Ateliers in Amsterdam. And this exhibition is sort of one of the first times that I'm showing a new body of work, which has been something that comes out of a much longer history of a painting practice that's been sort of interested in how gestures arise and are made. For the Towner Show, we wanted to talk about specific places and specific histories. So we, me and the curator Noelle, started developing an exhibition in which we were bringing the real spaces of historic overlooked female artists into the contemporary moment. So in the space, I've designed two standing steel structures, and what these are actual offcuts of the real apartment that the artist Elsa von Freytag-Loringhoven lived in. And in the second room, it's a real offcut of the apartment of the artist Janet Sabel, who was a painter, who was a contemporary of Pollock and perhaps making drip paintings before Pollock. So what we wanted to do was have the sense that the audience was walking through almost a sort of ghostly memory of these spaces. So all of the works are made by having live scale models in my studio where I take real objects and hang them and move them around and photograph them. And then I start with those as the basis for live paintings that are oftentimes rehearsed. In some of them you see a scarf or a rope or a belt, and those are real objects that have actually been exposed to silkscreen and printed life-size. And then alongside those, you have maybe digital renderings of gestures as well as documents, and then sort of gestural marks that are made in a variety of manners. And then also in most, if not all of the paintings, there's a small abstract painting in them. And in a way, I see all of the paintings as being hanging devices for these small abstract paintings. These are sort of my works which enter into a sort of discourse with a history of gestures. And if you notice as you walk around, they are diverse. They don't sort of have a clear hand. And for me, that's actually important, that there's a sort of really wide sense of possibilities as a sort of abstract painter. That opens up in the process of making these works. This was actually made by rolling down sheets of paper on a 5-meter ladder with a friend in the wind, standing on a ladder with graphite pencils. And we actually spent an entire evening rubbing the surface of my studio building. And this is actually what the sort of 7.5 meter wide and up to the first floor looks like. The work is definitely sort of focused on the question of what does it mean to be an abstract artist now? What does it mean to be an abstract painter who is female in the terms of a legacy of gestures?
These questions have informed the paintings and interventions in the gallery space. While these considerations might sound philosophical, they translate quite clearly into the work of an institution like Towner. There are still far fewer solo exhibitions by women artists in public and commercial galleries. As curators, we endeavour to create a more equitable balance. It's fundamentally important to support the work of women artists, to exhibit works that incorporate fluid and inclusive understandings of gender and identity, to bring attention to artists who have been underrepresented historically. With solo exhibitions by Melissa Gordon and Margaret Millis running side by side, we create a kind of intergenerational dialogue.